Hi everyone, my name is Vivek and welcome to my YouTube channel. This is the 6th episode about Vue Basics. If you are new to my channel, then please don't forget to subscribe and hit the bell icon so you never miss out my new tutorials. In the previous episode, we worked on event handling and today we'll work on class and style binding. So the first thing we will do today is, instead of showing this text as a color, I want to show real color, like this. To do that, open your text editor and open your product.vue. In this span tag, under this div class variant, you can add the class called color box. But before that, let's organize the code so we can easily read them. So here we will add a class called colorBox. If you look at the CSS, you can see I have added some width, height and border to have some square shape. Below this, we can add this style attribute and we want to bind it, so you can add vbind and the object. So over here, we want to apply the background color. And the background color will be this variant color, which will show red, white, and black. You can check the site now, and you can see red, white, and black color. You don't need this text anymore, so you can simply remove all of this. Great. Also, even this product status is out of stock, we are still able to click on this add to cart button and the cart item is increasing too. To resolve this, we can bind the disable attribute in this button. Let's do them. Here you can add vbind disabled and disable this button if the inventory is less than or equal to 0. You can check the site now and this button is now disabled. Even though this button is disabled, it seems like this button is clickable. So in the CSS, I have added a class called disableState which will make the button disabled. So let's bind this class name in this button when the inventory is less than or equal to 0. So let's use vbind class. And our class name is disabled state. So this class name, if the inventory is less than or equals to 0. Check the site again. And this time the button seems disabled. Now let's see what happens if we increase this inventory. Let's say 5. The button is now activated and we can click on it. But if it is 0 again, it is disabled. Great. This is the end of this session. In the next session, we'll work on computed properties. Feel free to comment below if you have any question. Also, please don't forget to like, share, and subscribe to my channel to get more videos in the future. If you want some hosting companies, you can check the link in the description below. Thank you and see you soon.